just wrapped up a week here in Paris. We spent some time with Martine, the Microsoft MVP program manager, who explained how to get involved and the benefits of the program.
Welcome, Seth. Welcome to France.
Oh, I love it here. So for people that don't know what you do, why don't you explain what you do as a community program manager?
Yeah, I am the community program manager, also named CPM,
okay,
for a series of countries. France, French-speaking Belgium, French-speaking Switzerland, New Caledonia, and also the whole Africa.
That's a whole swath of the world that you get to help out with.
Yes, it is.
So for those that don't know what an MVP is, why don't you describe the program?
Yes, MVP, so it means Most Valuable Professional.
Okay.
It's a worldwide program, and Microsoft is awarding people, top influencers, mm-hmm, top experts, because they share freely their knowledge with other people.
What does it mean to share their knowledge freely? Why don't you describe that a little bit?
It means that they are very involved in communities. So they share that knowledge. It can be offline, you know, by organizing technical events,
okay,
by speaking. They can have also online contribution, like blogging, developing some projects through GitHub. This kind of technical activities which are shared with everyone.
That's awesome. Is there like a path for becoming an MVP?
You need to apply,
okay,
to be an MVP. And to do that, you need to be nominated by either a Microsoft employee or another MVP.
I see.
And when you will post your nomination, you will need to fill out all your contribution, all the community contribution you have delivered during the 12 past months.
Oh, okay. So that's not too hard to do, though. I mean, if basically every time you write a blog post, you speak at an event, is it that kind of thing?
Yes, but we only award the top expert, so the most expert and the most active in communities.
Oh, that's amazing. So in the French-speaking MVP community, can you give me examples of the kinds of things that MVPs are doing?
So some MVP organize events.
Okay.
And also they are delivering session, and we will have some MVPs tomorrow at the Ignite Tour who will deliver session and who will be presenting their community at the Community Hub.
So you mentioned Microsoft Ignite the Tour.
So Microsoft Ignite the Tour, it's a worldwide tour organized by Microsoft.
Okay. How many MVPs are there around the world, and how many MVPs are there here in France?
We have a total now of more than 2,550 MVPs worldwide. And we can have new MVPs every month. And in France, we have a total of 117 MVPs.
Today. 117.
Exactly.
That's amazing. It's so great to be with you. It's always a joy to speak with you and learn about the French community and what MVPs are doing.
Thank you, Seth. It's always a pleasure for me to have you in France.
Welcome to Microsoft Ignite the Tour Paris. I found a friend, Jean-François, who has been part of some activities here in France.
Yeah, I'm Jean-François Berenguer. I live in the south of France. And I am MVP since 2008 now,
yeah,
on the cloud and data center platform. And I'm also a leader of a community in South, which is Azure DevOps meetup.
So you took part on the last NSDev Roadshow.
Yeah.
We went to South of France.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit more about what have you done during the roadshow?
During the roadshow, I first contacted a school just in near our office to have the opportunity to deliver the roadshow to the school. And after that, we also made a meetup on the specific topics on DevOps, and it was a learning party. It was a new way for us to deliver a meetup because it was an end on the lab. So we deliver a lab, and we have many participants, and they follow labs on DevOps technology like Kubernetes or containers on Azure.
Yeah, so basically, attendees of the meetup go to Microsoft Learn and actually are practicing a module on Microsoft Learn.
Yeah.
And then we were here together to help them
go
to the end.
It was fantastic for us because it was the first time for us to deliver a learning party.
What excites you the most to be part of the tech community in France?
Oh, in France, we've got a very huge technical community with Microsoft. We have many, many communities, but we all work together. It's very, very exciting to be part of this and to meet all fellow, all MVPs, all technical experts in France. So it's very interesting for us.
Right. Thank you for your time. Yeah. Have a great Ignite Paris. And
thank you.
See you around.
And I'm so lucky to be joined by an MVP and an RD. Why don't you introduce yourself?
I'm Estelle Obrex. I'm an Azure MVP and I'm co-founder of Azure GFR, which is a Francophone Azure user group.
Uh-huh.
And also creating a new community at Clouder City.
That's amazing. So tell me, how did you become an MVP and an RD?
I used to receive an email each year for 3 or 4 years by Microsoft, a really nice email saying, you're eligible as an MVP, would you want to be one? And I used to say no, because I thought that becoming an MVP will oblige me to say everything nice about Microsoft.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't want to do that.
No. So what made you change your mind?
I had an interview with Martine.
Okay.
And she told me, don't say bullshit, but just say we still have to work on it. And that's what I'm doing.
No.
She explained us everything about Microsoft, about the mind of Microsoft, and she's really helpful to introduce us to the right people at Microsoft, because it's a huge company, so we should have the right contact in Microsoft.
So what kind of technology stuff do you teach, build? How you said you're an Azure MVP.
Yeah.
What kind of stuff do you work on?
I'm mainly working on cybersecurity and IoT.
The good stuff, as we like to call
it. The funny stuff.
The fun. That's right. So tell us, how did you meet? How did you get her into the program?
So I met her, I had a discussion with her at the Microsoft front in the cafeteria, explaining her about what the MVP program is. And then after a few months, she became an MVP. And 2 or 3 years after, she also became a regional director.
So do you get to say whatever you want still?
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah. And the first surprise for me is that the French MVP and also with foreign MVP, it's like a family, and I really like that.
That's amazing. We just left Microsoft Ignite the Tour, where we met some passionate MVPs and learned about what they're doing to contribute to the local developer community here in France. Be sure to head over to mvp.microsoft.com to learn more. There you'll find a list of all the local MVPs in your region. They are here to help. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe to Code Stories to see what else we're up to this week in Paris and where we go next.